Hello and welcome to Credit Matters TV. I'm Ernestine Warner and I'm a member of the Structured Finance team here at Standard & Poor's. Today we'll be talking to John Detweiler, Director, and Associate Matthew Mitchell. John and Matt are credit analysts covering the Canadian structured finance and in particular the ABS sector. They recently authored a new report, which is the focus of our discussion today. The report is The Canadian Credit Card Issuer Profile, which was published back in January 2012. The report can be found on S&P's Global Credit Portal. So hello and welcome, John and Matt.
Good morning.
Okay, John, I'm going to start with you. If you could give us a bit of color on the credit card report, the Canadian Credit Card ABS report.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. We've been looking for a way to expand our research coverage in the credit card sector, one of the largest sectors in the Canadian structured finance market. And our main goal with this report is really to increase ratings comparability and transparency. We're often asked what goes into the credit analysis for these securities. And so we think this report addresses that by showing some detailed, specific base case and stress case loss assumptions that we use for each issuer in the credit card sector. We've been publishing a similar U.S. Report since 2009, and this report for the Canadian market really parallels that. With the introduction of the Canadian report, market participants are now going to be able to compare issuers directly by geography and amongst themselves. And then throughout the year, we expect to update this as we go.
Okay, so John, how does this report differ from the monthly credit card quarterly index that you published?
This report really complements our credit card quality index, the CCQI you referred to. That report is a monthly aggregate statistic that aggregates all of the issuers we rate, their payment information, their loss rates. So it's a blended statistic, whereas the credit card report we just put out breaks out performance, key performance variables on an issuer by issuer basis. So they really work together and are meant to be used concurrently.
Okay, so let's bring Matt into the conversation. Matt, if you could tell us how the credit card receivables have performed recently and also give us your outlook for 2012.
Sure. We've been tracking the performance of Canadian receivables through our monthly CCQI, as John mentioned, since 2001. Since that time, the charge-off rate in Canada has averaged around 4.1%. During the recent recession, we saw charge-offs increase to as high as 6.5% in October 2009. However, these have now declined and were 4.3% as of December 2011. This is approximately a 16% improvement year over year. For delinquencies, we've seen them also come off their peak reached in February 2010 of 4.3%. They've been stable over the past 6 months between 3.2% to 3.3%. For payment rates, they remained extremely strong in Canada during the recent recession, and we believe this is a result of the large number of convenience users in these pools who pay off their balances in full each month. The payment rate has been improving over the past 12 months and was 30.7% as of December 2011, compared to 27.8% the year earlier. And for yield, we also saw a large increase in yield during the recent recession. However, this was largely a result of the inclusion of interchange to Golden Credit Card Trust portfolio starting October 2009. Year over year, yield has increased from 19.3% up to 19.9% in December 2011. As for our outlook for 2012, in our baseline economic scenario, we foresee unemployment rising towards 8%, but remaining below the last recessionary peak of 8.7%. Under this scenario, we foresee charge-offs increasing slightly in the near term, however, remaining in the range of 4 to 5% overall in 2012. In our pessimistic scenario, we foresee unemployment increasing to as high as 10.3% in the first half of 2012. Under this scenario, we do foresee charge-offs increasing higher to a range of 7.5% to 8.5%.
Okay, Matt, I think you mentioned that you also published a U.S. credit card issuer report. Could you tell us what are some of the similarities and differences between the U.S. and Canadian credit card markets?
Sure. So one similarity we observed was a very high correlation between charge-offs and the unemployment rate during periods of economic stress. We observed in both countries during the recent recession correlations approaching 100% between these variables. Given that the unemployment rate's recently been increasing in Canada, there continues to be a very high correlation, and we expect this to continue through 2012. As for differences, we generally see lower charge-off rates and higher payment rates in Canada than compared to the U.S. We believe these lower charge-off rates are driven by the more widespread practice of relationship banking in Canada. where borrowers combine more of their credit with one financial institution, and as a result, that bank really has a better idea of that consumer's total financial picture. For payment rates, as we previously mentioned, there's a very large number of Canadian borrowers who are convenience users, using their cards really to collect rewards and paying their balances off in full each month, as opposed to financing purposes, which is more widespread in the U.S.
Okay, thank you, Matt. John, sort of coming back to you, if you could please give us the outlook for the Canadian credit card sector for 2012.
Absolutely. We've already seen a lot of activity so far in 2012, just 2 months into the year, about $3.7 billion in issuance. And our total issuance expectations had been around $4 to $5 billion for Canada in 2012. We've since moved that up to around $6 to $7 billion. One of the drivers behind that, the strong volume, has really been on the area of cross-border issuance, where Canadian issuers have tapped U.S. markets directly. Given the high investor demand for credit card ABS, we think this will continue. We think other Canadian issuers may be tapping U.S. markets during the remainder of 2012. As far as performance goes, the credit quality of the receivables continues to improve from the peak charge-off and delinquency rates we saw in the fourth quarter of 2009. And one of the reasons why our outlook is stable, it's improving. That said, Canadian borrowers could face higher delinquencies in the coming year if the economy were to suddenly slow down, if we observed a sudden spike in unemployment or the housing market weakened. And that's something we're keeping an eye on.
Okay, well, John and Matt, thank you very much for sharing some of the details of the report as well as your outlook for the credit card sector in Canada and also in the U.S. And thank you for joining us on Credit Matters TV.